Just got this from Amazon. 2-day shipping. I usually don't have it in the original, you know, shipping box because, you know, Thanksgiving holidays is here, and this is the NVIDIA Shield. If you guys remember me doing the first one, which is even shrunk and smaller, the controller got better, and this is a 16 gigabyte. The specification is a Tegra X1, 256 core NVIDIA graphics, 64-bit CPU, 3 gigs of RAM, 16 gigabytes of storage. Obviously, you can use USB expansion. And the other best thing about this, it has Chromecast built inside of it, so you don't have to have those separate Chromecast. You can cast everything from your iPhone to your Android onto your TV. Not many products excite me as they used to anymore, because once you've been doing a lot of products and you're used to getting a lot of stuff that you order or people coming in to send you stuff, the excitement kind of goes away. But then this is something that I really, really enjoyed, and I know that you guys are going to like it because you guys have been looking for a console. I feel like I'm talking really fast and my nose feels stuffy. Hopefully I'm not getting too sick. But tomorrow's Thanksgiving, and a lot of stuff is going to be going on sale, and maybe your parents are saying, give me your Christmas list, so you're going to get the remote controller. And I will say, I paid $160-something for... Whoa, this feels cold. This feels almost metal. Oh, it is metal. What kind of Christmas list would you like to make? And this is something... Look how... Holy crap. This is at least half the size of what the old one was, so I like to see that it's super small. Doesn't really need a lot to power that. And look at that remote. That remote looks cool. Yes, I will get to it in just a little bit. It's a little bit different setup than last time, it feels. And it's going to be micro USB cable. There's more support guide. And then what else do we get in there? Here's the power cord, and it is a... you have to use their own adapter, so you're not going to be able to power this up with USB-C or a micro USB. But that's not a problem. Let's put this to the side. Okay, you've seen all the components. I don't really need these for right now. And this is just an unboxing just to showcase what I have again, and I'll be able to do more videos and more hacks with a lot of different apps that you can run on this Shield. And of course, I will run my emulators like regular Nintendo, Super Nintendo, Sega, Nintendo 64, maybe even PS2. But I do have an external hard drive that I could expand the memory on this thing. Too bad it doesn't have a micro SD card. That would have been a lot better. Obviously, we have two super speeds, HDMI, Ethernet, and the power connection. Nothing else on the top portion, but this is a touch-sensitive power button, so if you touch it, it'll turn on and off. And it's so light. It's rubber on the bottom, but it's still slippery. It's not as grippy as other. And then, of course, the vent here for it to breathe. But that's it. This thing is teeny weeny. I think the remote looks really cool this time. The other one was really bulky and ugly. Hopefully, I'm showing you some little clips of what it looks like last time. But again, this is just an unboxing impressions. Just to get your attention again, let me get the Xbox controller. It's very similar to the size now. It's not all super bulky. You can see it does have a pretty good weight to it. Hopefully, it rumbles. Now, the pattern to it, you can actually feel every triangle, but it's not annoying like you feel... Like it's like uncomfortable to hold. You can just feel that it's there. The buttons are pretty quiet. I like that because if you're clicking a lot in there, the toggles don't feel that loose. They're really comfortable to move. And then the triggers, they feel a little bit like the PS4 controller. And then the bumpers. I like how everything's quiet on this. And of course, this is going to be recharged. You don't set batteries in there. You just plug it into the micro USB port. On the back, you have your headphone jack plug-in. So you can put your headphones in there. And then this is your back. This is your play and your home. This button on top here, if I hold it, it'll turn on, and the LED. So that's what really is about this controller. Now onto this controller. This feels really good. It's cold, like I said. Metal in the back, plastic in the front. It definitely has some good weight to it. Clicky, quiet buttons, and you could also do Google commands. The battery's gonna start going in here, and I'm not sure how to open it. Okay, I'll learn how to open it on the next one. So again, this is just the first impressions unboxing video, letting you know that I have it. If you have any questions, what do you want to know, leave me a comment down below, and I'll read it, and I'll make sure I'll answer it on the full review. More of a showcase, doesn't really need a review. Without even powering this on, this is gonna glow, that little green portion, so I have a little nice accent to it. But I will tell you, with my last NVIDIA Shield that I had, I got rid of it because I had an Xbox, and I felt like I didn't need it. Now I don't have an Xbox because I converted to PC gaming, but then my TV kind of got left alone, and I want to get back into some kind of gaming on TV. I can take this to places, to families, to friends, and load up all my movies and emulators to play off of this. It's going to be great. I for sure recommend this to be on your Christmas list. I hope you guys have a great turkey day, and as always, I will see you guys next time. Later.